our topic for today, which is the chapter Understanding Our Environment. So let's look at our first topic that we have under Understanding Our Environment is to first understand what the term environment means to us. We have different people who say different, who have derived it with different definitions. But what we understand is our immediate surroundings, a place where you have plants or plants and animals that live, or they dwell in that particular region. It need not be only plants and animals. Even we human beings survive in a particular environment or a geographical area in the case of flora and fauna. So that's what we conclude environment by saying that it is our immediate surroundings that we live in. Now, what does our environment actually consist of? Now, we have two important components of our environment, which is our biotic and abiotic factors. Now, your biotic factors is basically our living organisms that are present. Let's look at right from microorganisms to the highly evolved species on the surface of the earth, which is human beings who survive. So, we completely form the biotic components or the living things in a biotic environment. Coming to the abiotic environment, the non-living things, it could be with the temperature, the humidity, the soil availability, water, minerals that are present, all these form the abiotic factors of our environment. So each one is dependent, like we depend on our environment, like we depend on water for our survival, we depend on the atmosphere, that is we depend on our air for respiring, so we depend on oxygen. So basically oxygen, which helps us to respire. So all these are part of your abiotic factors. Now we have something called as environmental studies, which is an integrated and an interdisciplinary field. You have so many fields. If you look at this chart over here, each field is contributing something or the other, something or another part to environmental studies. So let's go into understanding what each one means to us. When you look at ecology, we say how an organism actually interacts with the environment. Like I just told you, how you have your plants and animals that are interacting with the environment. It could be any type of an environment, like, you know, say suppose you have a certain species of plants which are living in a desert region or which are living in a tundra region, how they interact with their environment for their survival. So that becomes ecology. And now again, you have the other topic, which is biology. Both of these are in more sense, they are very much interlinked. When you look at biology part of it, let's look at certain species of organisms which survive. For example, if you look at a desert region, you have the camel, the ship of the desert, what we say. And you look at the polar region, you have the polar bear. They both have adapted themselves to their surroundings. Like you have the polar bear, which can survive in cold regions, and you have the camel, which survives in completely harsh conditions. And the camel has anyway, it has, you know, modified, you know, parts. If you look at even the plant for that matter, it has a modified stem, or it has your modified leaf, which can survive harsh conditions. So that becomes a part of living for certain organisms to dwell in their particular environment. Now looking at the chemistry part, environmental studies in chemistry. Now when you look at chemistry, what happens is we have different types of metals and non-metals and even heavy metals that are present in the atmosphere, that are present in soil, that are present in water. What do these elements have as an impact on the environment? Now when you're looking at soil studies, or when you're looking at water for that matter, if you have water, say if you're looking at a polluted water, it will have lot of chemicals, it will have sulfides, it will have nitrites, all these are present in it in large quantities, which make that water unfit for drinking purpose. Now, on the other hand, when you look at soil for that matter, generally, even when you look at the construction of a building or an apartment or a house, whatever, soil is first tested to check whether that particular structure can be constructed in this soil or not. So you have soils which are tested on a regular basis for the construction. So you have your heavy metals again, which are present in water, like you have your nickel and iron, chromium. Again, that water becomes unfit for drinking purpose. So that's part of your environmental chemistry. Your atmospheric science, you would have all learnt in your lower classes, your atmospheric science, the layers of the atmosphere, the composition of the atmosphere. The composition of the atmosphere, you all know. You have nitrogen, oxygen, plus you have the other gases that is there, which is essential for the survival of any kind of an organism. If certain substances in the environment should be present in their respective quantities, if there is a change in their quantities, definitely it will have a negative impact on, be it a plant or an animal or whatever. Coming to the oceanography part of it. Now, when you look at oceanography and environmental science, so you will have oceanographers who actually go and study about the details in an ocean. Like it could be the surface, the ocean surface, the different rocks and minerals that are present in the ocean surface. Then, what type of an ecosystem. When you look at what type of an ecosystem is basically dwelling in a oceanic region, a marine ecosystem, the type of organisms that are surviving over there. Even your oceans are bound to get polluted. So when you look at your oceans, tend to get polluted is because of your oil spills that is there, or you will have basically littering or whatever littering done by human beings. So all these causes a problem. So you'll have an oceanographer who studies the pollution aspect of oceans. You'll have a person who studies about the soil that is the sandy soil that is present in your oceans. They will test on that soil. Then you look at the climatic conditions in that particular region. So that's basically the oceanography of it. Then you have your geology, which, as I've already told you, is basically the rocks and minerals that you find on your earth surface plus on your in your water surface. So that's basically the study of your geologist. Then you have your archaeologist. Your archaeologist basically will look at the past living of organisms that were there previously, which existed in the past. How did they survive? In what conditions did they survive? Today, what type of an environment are they living in? So it's nothing but a study of how organisms survived in the past and under what climatic conditions they survived, and how was the different types of how are humans interacting with the environment. So that forms the archaeology part of it. Anthropology is nothing but your how human beings are causing a effect on your environment. Actually, we are the major cause for today's environment, be it a negative impact or be it a positive impact. We are the major culprits who are causing a damage to our environment, whatever it could be as such. So we are actually bound to causing pollution, destroying ecosystems, and then bringing about health issues among human beings, or any extinction of species. So all these comes under your anthropology. Then history. When you look at history, when you're looking at studying of environmental science and history, it is what was the past of our planet? How did organisms look like? How did they survive? And how can it be modified in the future? Now, when you look at your political science part of environmental science, let's take this example of your Kyoto Protocol, which was there some time back. Which spoke about the greenhouse gases that were present in the atmosphere in large quantities, which led to the increase in the average atmospheric temperature and whatever are the effects which we see in today's world. So what exactly is this? You had a lot of countries which came to a common understanding and which decided on a common protocol, thinking that you should not let out harmful emissions of carbon dioxide or any greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, which will have a bad impact on not only the environment, that in fact will in turn affect our own bodies. Look at engineering aspect of environmental science. If you see, you have your air pollution control equipments. When you study about air pollution control equipments, we have so many gases, so many metals, certain different types of chemicals that are present in the atmosphere, which is causing example like acid rain into the atmosphere. When you have sulfur dioxide present in excess quantity, or you have sulfuric acid present in excess quantity, it mixes with the water, with rainwater, bringing down acid rain. Now, how did this get into the atmosphere? These are all basically discharges from our industries or from our vehicles. Now, what has to be done? Now, when you look at the engineering aspect of it, we have varied types of industries. You have heavy engineering, you have large scale industries, which actually, before letting out their harmful gases or harmful suspended particulate matter into the atmosphere, these all are controlled using your engineering equipments. Now, what are they? You have wet scrubbers, you have cyclone separators, you have electrostatic precipitators. So all the gas is let into all these. Each one works in a different manner. So once all these are the gas is let into this particular machine, it traps certain harmful substances and gives out only a very less quantity of harmful suspended particulate matter into the atmosphere. So that becomes the engineering part of environmental science. Now, when you look at ethics, we say how you have your human beings, causing problem to our environment. It could be with respect to environmental pollution, it could be with respect to depletion of resources, or it could be with respect to loss of biodiversity, destruction of ecosystems, global climatic changes are all part of your environmental ethics. That is with respect to what we say as the integrated and interdisciplinary field